thank you.
Yes, she does.
And you are okay with that. Right then. Dear Zen and Ting, I pronounce it well, do I?
Yes.
Welcome to your own day. From now on, the 5th of October will be the special day. It's your day. Today you are going to seal your relationship. And it's a special day to honor and celebrate the love you have for each other. You've chosen this particular date for purpose, and later on I will explain why the 5th of October was the best date, well, actually the second best date for you to get married. Spoiler alert, it has to do with the festivities that we have been celebrating in this beautiful town for the last couple of days. A warm welcome as well to all the guests of this wedding, a small but very close group of friends. And although we are sitting in the splendid city hall of Leiden, this ceremony feels quite intimate, thanks to you. And what you maybe know, or maybe not know, is that Zen and Xing's marriage is not only special because of the fact that it's them getting married, it is also a special event because it's the first wedding in over 2 years to be held at this particular city hall. A place that we consider as the Wembley Stadium of Leiden weddings. The city hall has been under reconstruction for over the past 2 years, and to me it's an honor to perform this first wedding, your marriage, and this beautiful location. And you have to know, for me it's the first time as well to seal a wedding at this location. And therefore it's not only you having this people getting married here, but me as well. Let's make it a good one. When we met about a month ago, you both told me you would prefer a simple, relaxed and casual wedding. The main reason you want to get married is of course the love between you two, but things have gotten a bit more urgent. Now Charlie's on his way. It's not a secret that his name's Charlie. Yeah, otherwise, sorry. it's more urgent now. Like you told me, if it hadn't been for Charlie, we might have waited until our parents would be able to travel to the Netherlands. But the situation is different now. And since I got to know you as two pragmatic persons, I fully understand your choice to not wait any longer. Nevertheless, it would have been nice to have your family on your side today. And it's a pity that due to COVID, you both haven't been able to see your parents for over 3 years. We know that in your hearts and minds, your parents are with you today. You both told me about your nice childhoods back in China. Xing, you were born up in a northeast city next to the sea, and your father worked for the Navy. That must have raised your interest in shipbuilding and maritime construction. Your mother was a high school teacher, and as almost all of your friends from your generation, you grew up being an only child. You were a serious student. You told me, I spent a lot of time on homework and studying. That paid off in a position at one of the four biggest universities in China, where you studied NATO architecture. Well, it sounds complicated to me. Zen, you were born just on the other side of China, in the south. I don't think I'll have to explain here that we're almost literally talking about two worlds apart, isn't it? However, your childhood was not very different from Xing's, because being an only child as well, you described your youth as nice and comfortable. Your parents worked in a bookshop, and that gave you the privilege of reading books and listening to music all the time. It raised your interest in jazz, correct, isn't it? And beside that, you were fond of playing soccer. When you were 18, you left your hometown for a study computer science at the university on the other side of the country, exactly in Tim's hometown. You were attracted by the nice climate and the sea. From what you told me, it's all the contrary from where you come from. Imagine that it's quite possible that back then, in that time, you already crossed each other on the street. That's a nice fantasy, but you both had to wait a few more years to actually meet each other. To be precise, in very small country in Europe, here the Netherlands. How did you both get here? You both always wanted to study abroad. Jean says, I've always liked Europe. I'm interested in culture and history, and I like to visit museums and exhibitions. With my background, I didn't have many choices. Delft is one of the best universities in my specialty. Moreover, people speak English here very well, and I know that people are open. So when I was 22 years old, I moved to Delft. I liked it right away. The climate is quite similar to my hometown, and I like people being so open. Then you also moved to the Netherlands, but ended up studying Twente. A bit against your will, because you also prefer to study in Delft, but the scholarship you got did not permit you to go there, correct? Otherwise, it would have been the second time you could have met on an earlier occasion. Look how fate has been fooling you twice. And like you say yourself, it could have been. In Holland, we use the proverb, drie keer is scheepsrecht, which means three times is charm. And we'll come to that soon. There, you found a job near Leiden in 2013, at Swift Banking System, and moved to Leiden. Then you started to work at the well-known Heerema Marine Constructors in 2012, and that's why you moved from Delft to Leiden with two friends and a partner. And this is where your story finally comes together. We have to wait for it. Your roommate was a colleague of Zen, and at the 7th of October, 2014, and you met each other at dinner. To be precise, having spare ribs at the Eigenwijs restaurant at the Hoge Rijndijk. You know it, don't you? You like spare ribs. All right. Still, you try to go there every year on the 2nd of October. You told me, have you been there this Sunday? No! Well, that first dinner, you actually didn't talk that much with each other. Sien remembers that Sam was very polite and talked about his hobbies. And Sam, you remember that Sien didn't say very much. But you also say, that's what I like about her. I like the fact that she's calm and likes to observe in silence. But at a certain point, when the group went to a bar after dinner, you spent several hours talking to each other without stopping. And it went all quite natural. So the next day, you asked her if she wanted to join her with you to the Oktoberfest festival. Sien remembers he showed me his football skills at shooting games, where he won an inflatable hammer. That's quite something you actually did there. After the first day, it was clear that you really liked each other. On the other hand, you both didn't feel like going too fast. It took about 3 months before you actually called it a relationship. And that's what it still is today. Look where you are. Your relationship has grown solidly over the past years. You bought your house together, adopted Rudier, the dog from the Giants' friends, now being an important member of your family, but most of all, soon you're going to be parents of Charlie, and he is so lovely. When I asked you about your favorite moment generally together, Zen answered, the most unforgettable moment was that one morning in April, Sien showed me the positive pregnancy test while I was still lying on the bed. We were shocked and thrilled at the same time. It is a crown to your relationship that has deepened over the years. When I asked you what you liked about the other, Sien said, we can solve problems together, we also have fun together. Sien is kind and fun and chill, sometimes too chill. And Sien, you said, she is my dearest friend, my soulmate, and my one and only. She Sin is smart, calm, and introspective. Since the day I met you, my life has never been the same. I appreciate everything we went through together. I'm looking forward to the next chapter in our life. And that's what love is about, and what marriage is about. Stevie Wonder sang it wonderfully in the song, Welcome, sit down, cook paper off. You didn't miss the most important part.
Okay, that's great.
Sit down and relax. I was talking about Stevie Wonder. We were listening at the beginning of the ceremony because he said it beautifully. He sings, and though you don't believe that they do come true. For did my dreams come true when I look at you? And maybe too, if you would believe, you too might be overjoyed, overloved, over me. This is why you decided to get married. Of course, you'd prefer to get married on the 2nd of October, but 11 days obviously not the best day to get married. So that's why you skip to the second. That's why you skip to the second best, and this is a beautiful Wednesday morning, at the 5th of October. This might be a good moment to explain you to what you're going to say yes to in a few minutes. You are going to promise to adhere to about 50 laws with rights and duties. The articles on marriage are stated in the Civil Law Book 1. Just in case you ever get bored, feel free to look at it. But I'll explain one of the most important articles of it. And that is Article 81. It says, spouses owe each other faith, help, and assistance. They are obligated to provide one another with those things. That means so much as provide the other with what she needs. And that is when you can get non-legal terms, but pretty solid advice. And from what you told me about yourselves and each other, I'm sure you'll be fine. And I guess the witnesses to your marriage will agree to that. There is Yati Brenner. One of the oldest and closest friends in the Netherlands. Ever since we met each other in Delft about 12 years ago. And there is Minji, I hope I pronounced it well. You were a Zen's classmate at university back in China, moving to Europe at the same time. They have the honor to seal your love with their spirits. Dear Emma, this is the moment I want to invite Ben and Shin to stand up. And lay the flowers down because I ask you to hold hands firmly and look each other in the eye. I ask the photographer, are they on the right spot? Yes. Okay. Because the pictures have to be beautiful as well. It's important. That is what remains of this day. And a lot more. Right. It's time for the yes word. Zen Shen, do you solemnly declare to take Shin Shen as your wedded wife? And do you promise to fulfill all obligations which are connected to law by matrimony? What is your reply to that?
Yes.
Shin Shen, do you solemnly declare to take Zen Shen as your wedded husband? And do you promise to fulfill all obligations which are connected to law by matrimony? What is your reply to that?
Yes.
Then I hereby declare as a register of the municipality of Leiden, in the name of the law, your marriage sealed, and you may kiss each other as long as you can. Worth come sit down because you are going to sign here, and then later I'll ask the witnesses to come over. Is it okay? I think it's good.
24 little hours. Walk the sun.
Congratulations, and please